Hello, I'm Fast Lawyer. Today we're doing a Let's Play and early impressions for Rhythm and Beats VR, a game that was released on the Steam Store March 15th, 2024. It's a budget price drumming simulator. It normally retails for $5. It's on a release sale 40% off, and that's a big discount for a low price game. So it comes out to only $3. I received a free Steam key through the Steam Creator Connect program to review this game, and I debated whether to even do a video or not. And I'm going to be honest, perfectly honest with you guys, this drumming simulator is substandard. And what I mean by that is, if you compare this drumming game to other drumming games in VR, it falls short, and there are several reasons why. Just the look and feel of the game, you know, just playing the actual drums, it just doesn't feel as good as other VR drumming games. It hardly feels like you're drumming at all. It feels more like you're just matching the colors that come on the screen. You know, the UI is ugly. The map is not very good. There's something wrong with the map itself. There's like an issue with the lighting. I tried to make it brighter or darker. It doesn't seem to matter. It seems to always not look very good. I guess I'll brighten it up, since I guess it looks better than the darker one, but it just doesn't look natural. Now there are some songs that come along with this game. So these are the songs that come along with this game. So there's some in-game songs, and you know, they're not too bad, but you know, nothing you've ever heard of. You know, I think these are all the developer created these songs, and congrats to the dev. You know, they're not too bad, but it's the gameplay that falls short, and just, you know, the look, the feel, the UI, you know, everything just feels so sloppy. But this game does have one saving grace, is that you can play your own songs. Now, you can use MP3s, but we're not going to do that, because obviously the best idea, something that nobody has, and I'll say this for this developer, because, you know, like I said, it's not a good drumming game, but there hasn't been one single drumming game that I've ever played that's been able to use YouTube and be able to make really good drum songs from that. Like, be able to process the song and come out with something that's really good, you know, comes close to reproducing how you would actually play the drums for that song. And this game is no exception. I think it just goes with the main beat. It's okay. It's not the worst, but it's not the best. But I'm going to play desktop audio, and I'm using YouTube. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and just play what I already have ready. And let's go. And we're gonna play. And I don't know why the game puts this on desktop, but it doesn't matter. I think my game's still recording. Let's go ahead and play. And let's click play. We're gonna go on next on. Let me stop. Let's go back to main menu. I've already messed up. That was expert mode, and I thought expert mode might be close, but let's do insane, because expert just is too simplified a version. Hopefully insane saves this. I don't think it will, though. I don't think it will. Let's try that again. By the way, if you couldn't tell, that System of a Down, Toxicity, one of the best drumming games ever. I mean, one of the best drumming games. One of the best drumming songs ever. But let's try that again. Let's go to Play Desktop Audio. We're going to click play. We're going to go insane. And we're going to play the song. So let's go ahead and do that. And I... Ah, crap. We'll be right back. obviously there's only so much you can do when you only have 4-piece drum kit. Okay, let me pause the YouTube video. Okay, so keep in mind this game is only $3 on sale, so it's budget priced. So, you know, keep your expectations low. Like I said, if you're playing this in VR, by the way, this does support non-VR, so you can play it in non-VR. I don't know how it works in non-VR. I assume it's just keyboard controls for the drums, just match to color. But for VR, the major problem is, like I said, when you're drumming, first of all, you're not making any noise. But second of all, it just doesn't feel right. Like, the haptics are all wrong. It kind of feels like you're just touching the colors. There is some haptics. Like, right now, I can feel, but it's just like a slight little buzz. And it just doesn't matter how hard you swing or really anything, as you might be able to tell. So, this is what keeps it from being anywhere near the top VR drumming games. It's no competition. But like I said, it does have some positives. But the other negative would be the UI. It's really ugly. The map itself is ugly. So, you know, those are the negatives. The positives, budget price. It has its own music. There's in-game songs. And they're actually not too bad, believe it or not. You know, for a solo dev to create those songs, I thought they were okay, you know. Not the best I've ever heard, but not bad. But obviously, the highest positive is that you can play your own music. You know, you can drop your own MP3s into the folder and play them. Or the best thing is you can just play YouTube songs in VR. The problem is, and other VR games have attempted this, but like nobody has been able to successfully, you know, translate, you know, hear, you know, come up with an algorithm that hears the YouTube music and produces something that's, you know, semi-accurate to what's being played. And obviously it's hard to do that when you only have four drum pieces. You know, obviously that Toxicity by System of a Down has a lot more drum pieces than just four. So it's never going to match up, but it's just not even close. Sometimes you feel like you're playing something totally different than what's being drummed. There are some cool parts to it. You know, it wasn't like 100% off bass all the time. You know, it did match some stuff to the song, but yeah, it's not very good. I mean, could I come up with something better? Probably not, but I'm not a trained musician, so I'm sure there's trained musicians out there who could hear that song by ear and come up with something a whole lot better than whatever the dev came up with to come up with that algorithm to output that result, which is not very good. But it's only $3, and for that reason, I can at least give this a neutral 5 out of 10. Yes, I know, it's shocking. But keep in mind, I do keep price in mind. And for this price point, $3 on sale, I can give it a 5 out of 10. And I'm being very generous here because I am basically giving a sale price rating. So since it's 40% off, it's only $3. I can forgive all the negatives and still give this a 5 out of 10, a neutral recommendation. You know, you saw this video, you know what you're getting. So you know whether you want to spend your $3 or not on this game. But if even it was at normal price, I would not recommend this game. I think $5 is too much for this. I think $3 should just be the normal price for this game, because that's the quality of this game. $3 is already all that can be charged for this, because it's low quality. Anyways, I'm Vast Lawyer. This has been my Let's Play Early Impressions. Again, not a full review, just early impressions. But, you know, you can kind of call this a full review because, I mean, you can tell. I've already played a couple of songs and I can already tell about the game, you know. Having played other VR drumming games, there'd be no reason for me to put more time or effort into this because it's a low, it's substandard, like I said. But it's budget price, and there's enough here that I can at least give it a 5 out of 10 at the $3 price range. But anything more than that, I would say don't buy it. Don't pay full price for this, definitely. Anyways, I'm Fast Lawyer. This has been my Let's Play Early Impressions. If you enjoyed this video, found it useful, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And as always, have a wonderful day. Goodbye.